Dear students, today we will talk about another structure which can be used to write pseudocode, which is known as function structure. So before defining and using the function structure, we should try to understand why we need this structure. So whatever pseudocode we write, we give it a name, and then that name can be used by some other applications as it is. For example, if someone has written a pseudocode to represent the sorting, so it is taking input as a number and then it's sorting the numbers. For example, if someone has written a pseudocode to find that who has got the maximum marks in the class, so this is a pseudocode of finding maximum marks or maximum number. So we will give this pseudocode one name, like finding maximum. So wherever we need finding maximum kind of functionality, we will call this name, and this name or this function will come over there to help you, and you do not need to write it from scratch again at that occasion. So first of all, we should also understand that there are different names which are being used for representing the similar concepts in different programming languages and algorithms, like subprograms, subroutines, procedure, method, and function. So they have a little bit small distinctions, which we are not going to cover over here. We will be mainly focusing the word function as it is being used by Python, and as we are using Python language in this course to represent the pseudocodes. So how to use the function? So we have def is the definition word, and then we write it, the name of the function. And then, for example, we can also pass the list of parameters. So for example, we can define def sort. So def sort is the function which we have defined with the name sort. And this sort function has a list. So you need to pass a list to this function to sort it. So whatever we need to give as an input to the function, we can mention that thing in the list of this small brackets as a parameter. So this is an example of representing function structure. So for example, we have said def greetings. So this means whatever we will define over here, these four lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, all of them will have one name, that is greetings. And because we have defined greetings function with the word def, which is a definition keyword to define the functions. So then we have said count is assigned by 3, and while count is greater than 0, so print hello. So what this will be doing, you know, we have a RAM and we have a count somewhere in the RAM, and that has a value 3. So it is checking while count is greater than 0. Yes, 3 is greater than 0. So print hello. So hello is being printed on the screen. And then it is saying count is assigned by count minus 1. So this count becomes 2. And then it is going back to the while structure. And then 2 is greater than 0. Yes, print hello. It is again printing hello. Then it is coming to the next statement and count is becoming 1. Then it is going back while count is greater than 0. So 1 is greater than 0. Yes, this condition is again true. Then it will again print hello. And then count will become 0 with this statement. Count is signed count minus 1. And then it is coming again upward. And 0 is greater than 0. So this condition is false. This means this function is going to be terminated or going to be finishing. So wherever we want to print these three hello, we can simply write over there greetings. So wherever we write this word greetings, all of these statements, all of these four statements will be executed automatically, and you do not need to write all of these four statements again and again. So this is basically the advantage of putting things into a function. So let's have another example that we want to calculate sum of numbers from 1 to 100. As we did it last time, number is signed by 1, right? Sum is signed by 0, while number is less than equal to 100, sum is signed sum plus number, and number is assigned by number plus 1. So we know this code. This has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 statements, and we can give it a name, def calculate sum 100 small bracket and then colon. So wherever we want to execute these 5 statements, we can there write only calculate sum 100. So this statement wherever been written by you in another application, in your application, or by some of your friend, or by some of your predecessors or successors, whenever they write this statement, so these 5 statements will be automatically executed. So there is another concept which we want to cover over here, which is called the concept of indentation. So whenever we write code, we make it indent. What do I mean from indent is that we have written an if structure. So if not raining, and then there is another if temperature is equal to hot, go swimming, else play golf, else watch television. So from identation, we mean that the things on the same level should be identified, should be on the same distance from the left side. So which means if this if is correct, then you are going over here. However, if this if is incorrect, then you are going over here. So you are, if first if is false, then you are not executing these statements. So this means these statements are indented little bit with more space. So this is the meaning of indentation. So how it will perform, like if there is a raining, so if not raining, condition will be false, and it will come over here and it will say watch television and sit at home and watch television, there is no need to go outside. However, if there is not raining, then it will check another if. Temperature is hot. If the temperature is hot, it will say go to swimming. And if the temperature is not hot, it's cool, then it will say play golf. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned about function structure with examples. We have given 2 examples to illustrate that how the function structure is important and how it can be recalled from some other location. And then we have discussed the concept of indentation.